I am Nutifafa Doumon, an assistant professor of materials science and engineering at Penn State. So my research is in the energy landscape. It's been driven by my visit to a lot of places and seeing the disparity in energy distribution and access. So my focus is more on photovoltaics and optoelectronic devices. We look at the photophysics of these devices. Most of the devices we look at are the new generation type. So we are talking about polymers or organic materials, perovskites, and quantum dots. And one of the drawbacks of these technologies is that they have low lifetime in terms of their stability. So that's where we focus. We try to understand the degradation mechanism that happened to these new technologies under different stresses. And based on that understanding, try to improve their lifetime. In so doing, we'll be able to achieve a longer lifetime for them and mostly towards commercialization. So we look at all of that in our space, in my new lab, the Doumon lab in Penn State, where we also look at flexible and large area devices, because it's very important to create them on a larger scale for them to be commercialized. So basically, that's what we do. Originally, we moved from Montreal, so let me put it that way, right? So in the pandemic, we tried to apply for jobs. I never considered US. So the only time I considered US was NREL and Penn State. And one key reason is because of the ad, right? The ad says the one faculty that works in the space of energy, minerals, and materials, which looks complicated. And at the same time, a faculty that will also promote interrelationship between Penn State and other researchers, and not only in the US, but also in minority-driven communities. So we are looking at Africa, some part of Asia, and then the Africans in the diaspora. So that's what actually caught my attention in the first place. Then, when I came, everything just blew out of proportion. I see the facilities, the amazing staff, the amount of collaboration that is possible, that is already enacted, you know, inside Penn State is great. So that was the first thing that drew me, but what made me decide is the fact that we visited and the place looks cool. Family-wise, it's a place that you can grow with your family, because family is also important to me in terms of values. It's a safe place, community-driven, student town, and which is reminiscent of Groningen when I did my PhD, it's also a student town. So all of these factors actually pushed me to make a decision to come finally to Penn State. I hope to grow here more as a researcher, pursuing, again, in individual research, but also in a collaborative space. So I hope Penn State will provide a platform for me to grow as a researcher and also create a network, I mean, deepen more my network, and then also promote the mission and vision of the Material Science Engineering Department and also Penn State in that sense. And in a larger sense, because I mentioned earlier that I belong to AESEDA, which is the short form for that kind of interrelationship between Penn State and the diaspora, if you will call it, is to be able to be an actor in that direction. And I'm looking forward to that part of the project or the journey also. For me, it's very interesting to kind of collaborate with not people just around your surrounding, but also beyond that surrounding. So I'm looking very much to that. Yeah. So the Alliance for Education, so it's Alliance for Education, Science, Engineering, and Design with Africa. So that's a group that existed over the years at Penn State. But with this new mandate, what they're trying to do is to kind of create a visible collaboration. So they have a kind of a platform. So Penn State becomes the platform. And some of us new hires are supposed to be the anchor of that platform. So we need to do, so it's funny because it's like we have a double assignment now. So we need to do our research as an individual PI within Penn State. But also we need to serve as the link to other collaborator that may not necessarily come to Penn State or may have not even heard of Penn State. So one fun fact right now is that I have two colleagues, two people that I call them colleagues because they do research. I don't know them from anywhere. They contacted me and wanted to visit Penn State. So that's something in that direction. So that's what they want to promote. So they have different faculties in Penn State. It's not just me who are affiliated to that, I would say, organization. And their job is to think and promote this part of Penn State in a collaborative way, and especially looking at underrepresented minorities and the communities within Pennsylvania itself, and then also in Africa. So they are kind of establishing the bilateral relationship. So that could start from us, the PIs individually, but that will probably develop into a kind of MOU between the two institutions for bigger collaborations, yeah. So I speak French, write French, read French fluently as a first language. So that's a fact a lot of people don't know. So the first international language I learned is French. So English is actually the second. So I like pointing that out sometimes because you may not know, Penn State might need a service, or materials and department may have a visitor who only speaks French, and you need somebody to kind of corroborate that. So that's one fun fact. I love soccer, so which is funny, because I shouldn't be in the US if I love soccer. So I love soccer, not just watching it, but playing it also. So I'm joining the Materials Science and Engineering indoor team. I think we'll start playing this week. That's one thing I also want to put out there. But then I'm interested in the football aspect, so I now want to learn what is football and how it's played as a game.